I lost my hat Saturday, actually, then found it in a bin covered in sick. So I left it there. I wasn't really expecting the low step of things to sort of take off like it has. It was just like a bit of fun, really. And it's just gone from strength to strength, and now it's all I do, really. I used to have a lot of aliases, but I've sort of knocked them all on the head and just focusing on this. And I think that's a lot of the reason why it works, because I'm putting all my energy into one thing, which I haven't done in the past. I mean, I've DJed in the past and I've dropped all sorts of stuff, like bass and drum and bass or whatever, but now it is all sort of 4/4 house that I play. But I think you benefit from having experience as a DJ, because you can go back through older tunes that you can drop, and the kids might not have heard them, and like there's a few older tracks that you can play that, well, there's loads of tracks you can play from back in the day that sound kind of like what's going on now anyway. I think it just depends what city or what part of the world, because I've played certain cities and the crowd's young and you can tell they kind of want it, you know, quite leery. But then I've played, say, like I've played Dublin and they've been a young crowd, but they've really like embraced sort of the housey side of things, so it's hard to tell really. I think different cities, even England being a small place, there's like different things going on and different vibes. I think there's been some cool London ones, like I've closed Ministry of Sound a couple of times, that's been cool. I played The Egg after Lee Foss, that was really, I really like The Egg, and I've never been before either, so yeah, that was wicked. Sankey's in Manchester, goes without saying, that was mint. So to be honest, the gigs are all really good, it's a really strong time, because I've been playing in England for years, and now it's definitely like, it's really good at the moment out there. Well, the Route 94 remix, I did it because I couldn't really play his version, but obviously I really liked it, so I thought I'd just kind of do an edit of it. And then he actually hit me up, he'd heard it and asked me to send it to him, and then he ended up sending me the parts and I sort of redid it. So that was just a bit of fun, but it's ended up being like, I don't think it's done me any harm doing it. I've had a lot of like love off it, really. And I think he was playing it himself for a bit, so that was pretty cool. The drifting thing, I suppose I had an idea what I wanted to do in working with a singer and stuff, so, and that one went on spinning. But yeah, the Route 94 was definitely a surprise. The So Real track, that was a sample, but now it's, we've had that re-sung, and the support on it's been crazy actually, because I didn't know how well people had sort of embraced that, but a lot of people have given me feedback on it, which I didn't think would really get into it, but I suppose you never know with music. And then there's some people that like the B-side, which is cool. So, yeah. I think one track that I play a lot is my remix of Hard Drive, Deep Inside. But so far that's still like underground, like nothing's happening with that yet. But yeah, I've been playing that all year.
And then you just obviously stepped out of the Rinse Studios today. How much do you actually enjoy doing those shows? There's a lot of preparation going to them?
Yeah, I really like doing the shows. I do spend days sorting through music, and like to get sent that many promos now, it's hard going through them all. But like I was saying, I do like to, you know, sort of still shop for my own music, which I think comes from me, you know, going in the record shops when I was a kid and going through music. I still find it nice finding my own stuff as well. Running a label as well, it does take up a lot of time, but I've got someone on board now to basically run the label with me, because it was hard going. I was like, I wasn't running it how I wanted to do, so I've got someone helping with that now, which I couldn't do it anymore by myself. There's that much going on, and it's getting back to people and listening to demos, it does take a lot of time. I'd say a guy called Scapes, he's going to do really well. Got an EP coming from him. There's a Dutch producer I really like called Ovis. I've got him on the guest mix on the new Rinse show. Yeah, I want to do a few collaborations. I think me and Frankie Rizzardo are looking at doing something. Also looking at working with someone, don't want to say too much, but another guy who's on spinning and looking to do something like that. And just push the label as well. I want to look into doing some parties for the label and push the artists that are on there. And just keep moving it forwards.
Christmas came early for Will. Okay, low stepper.
We've got three. Oh.
So, Will, got a little present, mate.
Thanks, man.
Enjoy
it.
Christmas came early.
Awesome. Get this on the train, innit?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You'll have fans all around you.
Oh, my God.